Every year, the average American eats as much as 33 pounds of cheese. That's up to 60,000 calories and 3,100 grams of saturated fat. So why do we eat so much cheese? Mainly it's because the government is in cahoots with the processed food industry. And instead of responding in earnest to the health crisis, they've spent the past 30 years getting people to eat more. This is the story of how we ended up doing just that. In the 1970s, Americans began paying a little more attention to their health. They began drinking skim milk. How do you make skim milk? You take the fat out of the milk made by cows. And these were no ordinary cows either. Through corn feed and hormones, the dairy industry turned cows into milk machines. That meant a lot of fat had to be taken out of a lot of milk. All this fat had to go somewhere. It went into making cheese, lots more cheese than people could ever eat. The dairy industry went to Washington and said, "You've got to help us here." So Washington spent billions of dollars buying up the surplus cheese and gave it to poor people through school lunches and other food programs. But even this couldn't keep up with the increased production. So the government stored the cheese in caves, and eventually the caves filled up. In 1983, the government put its foot down. It refused to spend any more billions of dollars buying unwanted cheese, but instead of pushing the powerful dairy industry to cut back on production, it came up with another solution. It found a way to help them sell more cheese by getting people to eat more cheese. The system they created is called the checkoff. Overseen by the Secretary of Agriculture, the industry taxes itself to raise money for promoting cheese and other dairy products. Each year, they raise nearly $400 million for advertising and other promotion. The food industry has been busy too. It sells billions of dollars worth of cheese every year. To get people eating more cheese, the manufacturers turn cheese into an ingredient, something that got added to other processed foods, which made them more fattening. Cheese ended up inside pizza crusts, in boxed, ready-to-eat meals, in peanut butter crackers. The result? All the fat that people tried to avoid by drinking less fatty milk began creeping back into their diets in the form of cheese. Since the 70s, Americans have cut the number of glasses of milk they drink from 267 to 60. At the same time, however, the consumption of cheese has tripled, adding 1,800 grams of saturated fat. It pays to look more closely at food labels. One thing is clear, you can't count on the government to look out for you.